Betsy, how would you say print in general and perhaps your publication specifically, how are they adapting to the new digital world?
I think it, from the beginning, certainly magazines and newspapers put content on the internet, and that was not exactly, it was successful with consumers, it was not successful from a business model perspective because it was basically giving everything away for nothing. When Time Inc. in particular saw what was going to be happening down the road with, especially with tablets and the whole mobile landscape and the opportunity that smartphones and tablets were going to suggest, we were early to market. In November of 2009, and remember the iPad was not introduced until April of 2010, we created a video with using Sports Illustrated as the flagship brand that was kind of a mocked-up demo, but sure looked real, of how, what a tablet might look like and what the user experience might be and what the advertiser opportunities might be. And if you go to YouTube, you can still find that video. It got a lot of attention. In February, when Steve Jobs first introduced the notion of the iPad, after all the buzz that had been going on, he used Time Magazine and Time.com as the content that he was showing. So that in April 5th of 2010, when the iPad 1 was introduced, the Time app was available for download from day one. And ever since then, and going ahead for the rest of the year, the majority of our brands have either full digital magazine apps or functional utility apps, things like the EW Must List or the InStyle hair app, so you can try your face on Cameron Diaz's hairstyle. So we're believers in the opportunities, and just as critically, we're believers in the business model of creating a consumer-driven business going forward. And now that we are able to provide digital apps to print subscribers through subscription authentication, we're starting to grow scale, and we believe that this will be an important business for us going forward. And from my own research perspective, besides just the excitement of being part of something so new and evolving, we have been doing research on tablets literally since that day, April 5th, 2010, by sending people from the research department to some Apple stores and then following people as they left with their packages to get their email addresses so we could contact them, so we could have them come in and talk to us about the experience. And we've been doing research on tablets pretty much ever since.
So let's talk about the type of research you're doing now at Time Inc.
We have, I'm in a great, there are people who don't like being in corporate roles, and there are people who love it. There are people, and many of them have worked for me, and now I'm in my second kind of iteration of this role. There are people who say, I don't like being in a corporate role, I like being part of a brand. And there are people, and I count myself as one of them, who say, I love being in a corporate role because I can work with every brand. So we do a lot of research at each brand, supporting edit and advertising, magazines, and digital. But what I also get to, what I get to do is conduct new research that's going to certainly help all the brands, but also produce new insights on something that maybe each of any of the individual brands just doesn't have the resource to fund individually. So our work with the iPad, unless it was specifically brand focused, has all been done on the corporate level. So our work with understanding the consumer experience of working with a tablet, having a tablet, has for the most part been done on the corporate level. And our work with biometrics, with the iPad, was done on the corporate level. So what we're looking at this year is enhancing that work, doing some additional work on what engagement looks like across a multitude of media, and I'm not going to say any more about that. Another thing that Time Inc. has been noted for is the work we've done on the purchase process. We have been doing work on the auto purchase process for about 15 years now, understanding from the time a consumer decides I'm going to buy a new vehicle till the time they actually buy it and beyond, everything that's happening in their lives, every influence in terms of what kind of car, what brand car, what's on their shopping list, how they get their information, how they talk to friends and family, how they use the media, and how they purchase, because that's changed as well. So we've been doing more purchase process studies. We did one a couple of years ago on consumer electronics. We did one on the wireless category. We did one on the purchase of golf products. We did one on the purchase of financial instruments. And we have two in the works right now. I hate being so secretive, but in fact, we're kind of right in the middle of everything that will, we believe, add to our attributes of being interested in things from a consumer-centric perspective and not just from a media perspective. So I know when I've gone in to talk to advertisers and agencies about these studies, it's also, whoa, you're Time Inc. and you're not just coming in to talk to us about magazines. And that's true. We're coming in to talk about the kind of holistic consumer experience, how magazines fit in, but how television fits in, how the internet fits in, where it fits in, and what's the best messaging, what's the best form of communication to use in each of these media to optimize that consumer experience. So more of that coming. We're going to be doing more work with our panel, our tablet owner panel, to again understand not just what the consumer experience is today, but how it's evolving, so that our content creators can produce the content that consumers want, so our ad salespeople can sell it to advertisers in the most appropriate ways. And something we're really excited about, and I think I'm allowed to talk about this, is that Time Warner is building a media lab in New York City, certainly a place where we can work with our clients to test content, to test advertising messages in a completely up-to-date, state-of-the-art facility with certainly focus group rooms and usability rooms and theaters and eye tracking and biometrics, and we're very excited about that.